How to become a field engineer. I love this topic because I was a field engineer and I became a field engineer. And I get asked this all the time. So in this video, what I'm going to talk about is my story, how I did it, and give you some keys for how you can do it as well. Because the position of a field engineer is not only to be a field engineer, which is a wonderful thing if you want to, but it also leads into so many other different career opportunities, especially superintendent, PM, and beyond. So if you're into that and want to know how to become a field engineer, then stay with me on this video. So I am with you. Now, at the risk of sounding arrogant, I want you to know that I'm a pretty good person to ask. Like, you know, somebody could literally type into ChatGPT, you know, give me the script for a video, film themselves on a video, and kind of fake it through. That's not what I'm doing with any of these things. I have done this. Wes Crawford, he's an emeritus professor, and he worked at Purdue University, wrote the book Construction Surveying and Layout. And like many others who I honor and respect, I've been working with him for decades now and really honor and love his work. And I grew up at Hensel Phelps and I created the most recent version of the training program that they still have at Hensel Phelps. I'm a pretty good person to ask here. Now, let me tell you my story before I begin. First of all, I was like 13 and a half in Southern California. I got a job with a tilt-up company. They do concrete tilt-ups. Or they did. I think they're still in business. Yeah, they're still in business. But anyway, now they do some civil and things like that. But I got to work there without a work permit. That was illegal, but I think the statute of limitations is up. And then got my official work permit when I was 15 and a half. But I started working there and I worked my way up to do equipment operation. I was a cement mason, a finisher, and I would do some form setting. I wasn't a full-blown carpenter. I don't know how to be a full-blown carpenter. I do know how to set forms. I grew up there, then had an opportunity. My dad was a ready-mix driver. He was actually like pretty high up and then soon became a truck boss, but he worked with his company at Hensel Phelps at a large prison. And one of the sales reps there got me an in. So I was able to start working at Hensel Phelps as a cement mason in the unions in Southern California. It was a great opportunity. I loved it. It was massive. Doing concrete placements for tilt-up panels every day. It was like the most massive. I might as well have been on a bridge project, like a massive bridge project. It was on a United States penitentiary. Absolutely amazing experience. But I hurt my shoulder finishing concrete. It's just one of those natural things. I don't think it was anybody's fault. I don't think that anybody was doing anything wrong, but it's just that natural movement. So I was down. I was like, hey, team, I can't do this. I'm like, the doctor says I've got to take some time off. So they gave me an opportunity. They said, would you like to be what they called a rodman for the field engineer crews? I was like, sure, that'd be great. So I was holding the level rod. I was holding the mini prism, the 4-foot prism, like doing a number of different, holding the end of the tape measure or a chain and just loving it. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is what I want to do. So I learned the total station. I learned how to use the automatic level. This is a fun story. I'm not saying you need to do this, but there wasn't really a budget for me to have a computer and not everybody else had computers. And this is when computers were first starting to be used in construction. I bought my own for $3,000, went into debt, and I hijacked an illegal license of AutoCAD and taught myself how to do lift drawings. Okay. And I've given AutoCAD or Autodesk so much business since then. I hope we can overlook that. Okay. Like, I'm talking like probably $300,000 worth of like software sales. Worked my way up and they're like, okay, you're a full-blown field engineer. Then made my way to lead field engineer. And candidly, let me say this, and this ties into becoming a field engineer. I started to fail. I got a little bit too big for my britches. I got away from my basics and I was about to get fired. I was having as a lead field engineer, I was having a hard time. And I was like, I got to do something. So I grabbed Wes Crawford's book and I said, I'm going to get back to the fundamentals. And I read that whole thing 8 times, not joking, 8 times. I got most of it memorized. Like, for instance, the order of accuracy for a level loop is on page 7-16. Like, I've got this memorized. I immediately started to succeed. Then Hensel Phelps said, do you want to start training in SoCal? Then it was in the whole district, and then it was throughout the country, and then created the training program. So that's how I got in. Now, let me talk about something really key here that I think you're going to love. And if you do, please like and subscribe. The best advice is you've got to get in. The best ways to do that are college education, fortunately or unfortunately. I love my college educated brethren and sisters. And I will say that you don't need that education to succeed, but most of the time you need it to get in. Or you can do it through a craft position, which I've seen happen a lot, where you get a break. The other one that I want to suggest to you, please don't be too good for it, internships. I have seen, oh my gosh, this is so important. I have seen project manager level people come from another company and then go back to work at a different company. In this case, it was Hensel Phelps, and starting as a project engineer, starting as at a little bit lower level and working your way up. So you've got to get in. That is the main thing you've got to do, is to get in with a company that does field engineering, whatever that looks like, even if you have to take an internship, even if you have to take a labor carpenter or finisher position, some other craft position. Once you do get in though, and you're starting to work with the total stations and the automatic levels and maybe even the robotic total stations and the GPS, and you're creating lift drawings, you have got to read, and this is great advice, the first 8 chapters of the Field Engineering Methods Manual version 3. We are currently, I am currently with Kate and Brandon Montero and a number of other people updating Wes Crawford's Field Engineering Methods Manual. It's titled Construction Survey and Layout to version 4. And we will have the first book be what you need. But if you're doing version 3, it's the first 8 chapters. If you're doing version 4, it's the first book. Learn it, study it, go through it, and implement every single thing. Some notable things, you know, like 3-wire leveling, always closing, estimating to the nearest thousandth, doing direct and reverse shots, right? Like closing things in a traverse. These are basics that will save you in that role. The next step I would say is begin practicing, if not becoming proficient with things like Revit or AutoCAD Civil 3D or just regular AutoCAD doing a primary control file or Google SketchUp or Tekla if you're doing mostly reinforcing or, right? Get really great. Putting together lift drawings will program your mind and enable you to go do layout and QC in the field with the craft more than anything else you can do. I remember Scott Berg, a general superintendent at Hensel Phelps, telling me, Jason, if we can't draw it, we can't build it. And that remains true to this day. So start practicing with lift drawings in Revit or AutoCAD and possibly in Civil 3D or some other applications. The next thing that I'm going to tell you is connect with the craft. Get in those trenches, get your boots muddy, ask them questions, connect on a deeper level. This will do 2 things. Number one, they will teach you more than anything else. And secondly, you will develop a respect for workers and foremen that will never go away. And that's what we need more of in this industry. Okay, so that's probably the biggest thing. And if you want to become a true field engineer, great field engineers truly partner with their craft. In fact, that is your purpose. That is why you exist, to enable the craft. So that is a key step in becoming a great field engineer. And then the last thing that I want to tell you is practice. If you have done total stations, but you're like, I'm ready for a traverse, practice it. The book will show you how to do it. Then you're like, oh my gosh, I'm ready for trigonometric leveling. Okay, go ahead and practice with that. If you've done elevations, meaning differential elevations or differential leveling, and then you're like, okay, now I'm ready for grid leveling. Now I'm ready for profile leveling. Or now I'm ready to run a level loop. Please, please keep practicing. And this is my last bit of advice, which is really, really great. You have to learn how to be an applied field engineer. In fact, the new version 4 of Wes Crawford's book will be Book 1, Fundamentals, Book 2, Applied Field Engineering. What that means is you have to understand how to go from your basis of bearings to a traverse and a level loop down to secondary control using baselines, shooting direct and reverse shots, turning angles, chaining distances, right? Like, you've got to understand how to take all these different components, the lift drawings, the layout, the traverse, the level loop, all these things, and tie them into a process. Into process steps. Step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, step 6. A great field engineer will learn the overall process and become an applied field engineer. These are my bits of advice. We have lots of other videos on field engineering on this channel and on our Lean Survey YouTube channel. And we will have these books coming out. So in the description below, I'll link you to the books, and I will invite you to reach out if you ever have any questions. We have lots of content, but that's how you become a great field engineer. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.